Every year.
And what is the theme of this year?
Of this year is Vision and Courage.
Italian Wine Podcast. Cin Cin with Italian Wine People.
Welcome to Italian Wine Podcast. It is a very, very special day today because we are here for Premio Masi. It is the 40th anniversary of this premio, and we're here with Mr. Sandro Boscaini, who is the vice president of the foundation, and he'll explain a bit about that, but also, of course, the lead and the president of the famous Masi winery. So, ciao, Sandro.
Ciao, Stevie.
Sandro, can you please tell us exactly what Premio Masi is?
It's a sort of celebration that we start in 1981, so 40 years ago, exactly 40 years ago, in a very difficult moment for our viticulture and enological situation in Italy and in particular here in Veneto. In fact, at that time, it was the right moment to start the new renaissance of the Italian wine in one side, but also some of the previous players still alive, they tried to work in a way that the new rule of the new law of the appellation should be intent like a way of marketing rather than a true law to change the life of Italian wines.
So when did it all start? The foundation, the Premio Masi.
The Premio Masi started in 1981.
And who came up with the idea? Like, how did it become?
In this situation of difficulty for Italian and Venetian viticulture, I expressed my concern to a few people in the culture, a journalist, a well-known writer, and a novelist, and other people. And they came to me with a very simple idea. They said, well, you should be very proud of what you are doing, what your father did, what your grandfather did, making true wines, serious wines from the Venetian region. What the best is to put in a your product at the level of the production of artists, scientists, entrepreneur that really make famous your himself and the Venetian area in general. And so they came. You have one of these example of a great product, that's Amarone. Why you don't give as a prize Amarone? And so we started with the Premio Masi, and the barrel of Amarone is the symbol of the premium, and is the reward that we give to the prized people. So from that time, 40 years came, 20 years in the last millennium and 20 years in the new millennium, and this year we are here to pay tribute to the history that came to us, recognition of the history through the prized people, as well to the innovation and the vision of the future that came through, in particular, the last 20 years, when the important person, Italians or even from foreign country, that came here, tribute to the prize and to the Masi name and to the Amarone, the position that Amarone have, and at the same time giving some vision for the new life, in particular now after this problematic time of a pandemic.
Okay, so can you tell us, for example, who were some of the past winners, awardees of Premio Masi?
Yes, I have to start to explain that the Premio Masi is given to the three different categories.
Okay, what are the three different categories?
The first category is the people that come from here, from this region, Venetian region, or that became and are to be considered like a part of this culture, and we prize the culture, the innovation, the ideas, the vision of these people that became famous all over the world. And we have people this year, we prized Roberto Battistone, which is a scientist, mm-hmm. and in particular a very active now. It was the president of the Italian Institution for Space. But today is also the mathematic system to analyze the evolution of the pandemic, for example.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I see three names today, right?
Jane D'Amosto, exactly. Jane D'Amosto, who is not an Italian. She married Mr. D'Amosto, Count D'Amosto from Venice, but she is from South Africa, mm-hmm. and she is a scientist also, but is also a very dynamic person on saving Venice. In more in general, to save the planet against the situation that is created today of pollution, etc., etc. And Paolo Fazioli, mm-hmm. is a musician, and in the same time is a very important producer, the first and the only one very important producer of a pianoforte in Italy.
Okay, so it's unusual that you have three awardees for the same category, is that correct?
Yes, no. Every year we change. This year is more or less all in line, but in general is one entrepreneur, one artist, and one scientist.
Ah, okay, so yeah. Three personalities,
exactly.
For the Civiltà
Veneta.
So you have the second category, which is called Grosso d'Oro Veneziano. And what is that about?
Is a prize. Grosso d'Oro is a coin that go back to the 14th century in Venice, in gold and in silver. That was well known in the Mediterranean area as well in the Asiatic area, in India, in the Asiatic area. And to give the impression that as the coin that go around the world making friendly everybody, when you can exchange it, the freedom to exchange, to know people, this is the symbolic product of the peace and the friendship around the world. So we prize a person every year that did something in this area. Italian or not Italian, mainly
okay.
Not Italian, but people that
but
really...
But it can be, an award, it can also be Italian.
Absolutely.
Okay.
In this case, for example, Elena Cattaneo, mm-hmm. is a scientist, but is also a senator of the Italian Republic, but more than that, she is a very strong supporter of the value of the scientific approach to the wellness and to the good life of the people all over the world.
Okay.
We cannot go back to the Middle Age. We have to proceed and to be open to receive the input and the help that come from the scientific approach. And then, lastly, la civiltà del vino,
yes.
International wine culture, that this year we give to the my friend and your friend Attilio Scienza, mm-hmm. one of the top person, or probably the top person today in the viticulture and the wine sector, professor of university, very deep in the culture of wine, the roots of the wine, the history of the vine, and so and so, and a person that did a lot to also to spread the message of the importance of the grapes, importance to the wine, and the culture of the wine that is a great culture in Italy, but not only in Europe and now all over the world.
Yes, we're so excited about this award to Professor Attilio Scienza. Just one last thing. How do you decide who the awardee is? Is there a committee who decides this? And
exactly.
Who are they?
There is a Masi Foundation have their own organic group of consigli, mm-hmm. The board of the and the board decide three different committee, jury, mm-hmm. one for the Venetian civilization, one for the wine, and then the Grosso d'Oro Veneziano is mainly taking care is the board of the, but with the suggestion of other experts. And so every year we do a careful selection. After that we gave the specific topic every
and
year.
And what is the theme of this
the,
year?
The of this year is vision and courage.
Courage, yes.
Courage. Vision and courage, because I think is a perfect theme for this situation post-pandemic, or that is approaching to the post-pandemic, mm-hmm. and we need to have a vision because the world will be changed in some way, and so courage to go in a new way, to experiment a new way, knowing that some of the past must be really destroyed, or in any case we cannot go with the same system.
Okay, so I actually want to just go back for the question that I had said before. Who were some of the previous or initial, when you started this, who were some of the awardees that we should know?
Oh, well, for example, we can start with the wine. The wine, we have the...
I'm wine-centric, so as you know,
I'm very interested
in the wine.
In the wine, I don't know, great producers like Philippine de Rothschild, for example, like Krug, mm-hmm. the family Krug, like Sandemann, but also people in the wine culture like Professor Peynot.
Émile Peynot. Oh my goodness.
Yes, I think it was the first.
Émile Peynot.
Actually, the first, it was the inventor of Vinitaly, Betty.
Oh.
The Betty. Second, it was Peynot.
Oh, my goodness.
So you are at home.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, and then other very important people, mainly foreign people, but also Italian people. For example, Incisa della Rocchetta, the Sassicaia owner,
right.
and other on the group of that make the selection. There is the friend of mine like Piero Antinori, mm-hmm. Angelo Gaia, some journalist, Italian, German, and American journalist, and it's a fun and it's very important for us, and I think for the culture of the wine in this case.
Well, that sounds fantastic. So Professor Attilio Scienza is in very, very good company indeed. And thank you so much for doing this. I know you're very busy today, so I'll let you go. But I do believe, you know, the way you are being inclusive, both of culture and wine together, and perhaps, you know, we can go a little bit forward in these difficult times.
Thank you.
And that's it. That's a wrap from the Masi Winery with Sandro Boscaini. Ciao, ragazzi.
Jake, thank you.
And that's a wrap for this episode of On the Road Edition with Stevie Kim. If you enjoyed today's episode, please make sure that you've subscribed to our channel and check out our other travel videos too. You can also listen to our podcast version. For more information, check out www.italianwinepodcast.com.